Hi boys and girls, good to see you. Thank you for tuning in to our Christmas special today. I'm going to teach a memory first, and then Jenny is going to come and teach our Christmas lesson. Boys and girls, have you ever got up on Christmas morning really, really excited about what you've got, and you've crept down to maybe the living room or the conservatory? It's dark. What do you do when it's dark? That's right. You get a light. You get a torch. And maybe you're shining the torch all around the room. Maybe as you come into the living room, you're sort of shining the torch around to see what presents you've got. Or anybody else would just turn the light on, wouldn't they? Yeah. Well, boys and girls, that reminds me of our memory verse today. A light lights up a dark room. And boys and girls, our verse today teaches us about a light. It teaches us about a light that came into the world. We're going to learn this now. Okay? So we're going to say it together. It's found in John Chapter 8, verse 12. Okay? After 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. You think you know who the light is? Yes, that's right. It's Jesus. You see, Jesus came into the world as a little baby. He was born in a smelly stable, in a little manger. And Jesus came into the world which was very dark. Jesus was the light in a very, very dark place. Let's say it again. After 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. You see, boys and girls, when I think of the world, I think of people who have sin. I think of people who are going their own way in life and have no interest in God. But you see, Jesus came into the world to die for people like that. He came into the world to die for you and to die for me. Boys and girls, sin is a big, big problem in the world. But Jesus loves everybody. That's why he died for everybody. Boys and girls, I wonder today, as we think of the world, we think of the mess in the world and the mess that sin has caused in the world, I wonder, will you ask the light? Will you ask the light of the world? Who's that again? That's right, Jesus. To come into your life and to take away your sins. This time, we're going to follow my clicker, okay? And what I want you to do is, we're going to follow my clicker, and when I say pause, you have to hit the pause button on your remote or on your iPad or computer, okay? And then tell me what word I paused at, okay? Are you ready? Think you can do that? We'll give it a wee trial run, okay? After 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in John chapter 8, pause. Okay, verse 12. Jesus said, pause, don't move. I am the light of the world. Okay, very good. Okay. Can you tell me the first word in our memory verse? That's right, Jesus. Jesus was the Son of God. We have been looking at that in our memory verse over the last couple of weeks. We know that he is the Christ. We know that he is the Son of God. But it also tells us that he is the I Am. Okay? I am the light. I am the bread of life. I am the resurrection and the life. Jesus is the I Ams. Okay? Maybe you could look that up in your Bible. Look up all the I Ams. Okay? So that's another name for Jesus. Okay? I am the light. That's talking about Jesus, the Son of God, the Christ. And of course, the world then reminds us that Jesus came into the world to save sinners, okay? Because the world is very dark, it's very sinful, and Jesus came to be the light, okay? So, do you want to play another game? Let's play a game of ping pong, okay? So I'll say the first word, and you say the second word, and so on and so forth, okay? After two, one, two. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus, I, the, of, world. Okay? You start first, okay? So you start with the word Jesus this time, okay? After two, one, two. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, said, am light the world. Super. Excellent. Well done, boys and girls. You've done really well with your memory verses. You've done really well in learning these verses. And boys and girls, we trust that you have a lovely Christmas, and we will be in touch with you very, very soon. Let's just say this once more before we finish. After two, one, two. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. I'm going to hand over to Jenny now, who's going to teach us our Christmas special.
Hello, boys and girls. Can you believe it's nearly Christmas? I love Christmas, don't you? What things do you love about Christmas? Let me guess. Do you love decorating the Christmas tree? I bet you love all the excitement of Christmas Eve when you hang your stockings up and you come down in the morning and get all your presents. And I bet you love having Christmas dinner with your family. I love all those things too. I'm sure you know why we celebrate Christmas, don't you? It's because Jesus was born into the world. Jesus, the light of the world, came. And why did we need Jesus to come? Well, it was because we had all sinned. There was the problem of sin in the world. But God hadn't forgotten that problem. Even before he made the world, God had a special plan, because he knew that we all needed to be rescued from the dangers of sin. He knew that every one of us had come into this world with sin in our heart. This wee symbol shows us what it's like to have the darkness of sin in our hearts. The Bible says in Hebrews, all have sinned. And that means you and me, we all had this darkness, this problem of sin, and we needed somebody to deal with it. Now, people didn't know when Jesus would come. Way back, even in the Garden of Eden, God had said he would send a saviour, but nobody knew when he would come. Thousands of years passed, and then it was the right time. On that first Christmas, God put a beautiful shining star in the sky. Can you imagine it twinkling and glowing? It must have been absolutely beautiful. God was going to bring light into the world, just like he did at creation. Do you remember? He said, let there be light, and there was light. God spoke, and it came into being. Every came into being when God spoke. He made the whole world just by speaking. He made all the lovely things that we have about us. He made the tiny snowflakes, every one of them different. And the things we love at this time of year, the scented pine trees, the holly with its berries, even the reindeer. And God made you and me as well. And because God made you, he loves you. It says in the book of Jeremiah, I have loved you with an everlasting love. That's a never-ending love. And because God loves you, he doesn't want you to be separated from him by the darkness of sin. That's why he sent Jesus, the light of the world, to come and rescue you from darkness. Now, on that very first Christmas, there were shepherds in the fields watching their sheep. Maybe they were huddled round a fire to keep warm. They didn't know that very soon Jesus, the light of the world, would be born. They were just watching their sheep. And meanwhile, far away, there were wise men. They had seen a great star in the sky, and they knew it meant something very special. They knew it meant a new king would be born, and they were following the star to see where it led. Some people say they were kings themselves, and they were bringing special treasures to give to the new king. And they traveled following the star. And in the meantime, there was a beautiful angel appeared, dazzling angel lighting up the dark hills around Bethlehem. And the shepherds saw the angel. And as they were looking up in awe, the angel was joined by a host of angels, a crowd of angels, all praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace. Now, what happened just after that? The Lord Jesus was born in a dirty stable at the back of the inn that had no room for him in the town of Bethlehem. He was laid in the manger, which was the animal's feeding box. And he was the one that God had promised to send. He was the light of the world. And they called his name Jesus because it means Savior, the one who would come to save us from the darkness of sin. He grew up obedient to his Father God, obedient to Mary and Joseph who cared for him. He lived a perfect life because he was the one, the only one who was without sin in this world. He did many miraculous things in his life, many powerful miracles, because he was God's Son, the only one who could take away sin from this world. Because sin is dangerous. And you might say, how is sin dangerous? Because it can separate us from God, not just now, but forever. Because God is pure and holy and can't have anything sinful near him. So Jesus grew up, and when he was 33 years of age, he allowed cruel men to nail him to the cross, because the only way to get rid of the punishment for our sins was for Jesus to take the punishment. He had to die on the cross and take the sins of the whole world upon him. And God allowed him to do that. That was the purpose he had come to earth, so that once for all, he would take the punishment for sin. And to do that, he had to shed his blood, because the Bible says, without shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness. So Jesus did that for us. He died on the cross. He took our punishment so that we could be free from that darkness of sin in our lives. And he didn't stay dead. He was buried in the tomb, and then God raised him from the dead. And because God raised him, he has power to forgive our sins. He is alive forevermore, and so he can give us new life too. If you want to have that new life, all you have to do is pray a prayer something like this. Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus, the light of the world. I believe he died for my sin. Please take all my sin away and give me this new life and help me to live for you every day. Amen. God will always hear your prayer and he will answer it. And then all the darkness of sin can be taken from your life and you can have this lovely clean life that God wants to give you. I hope, boys and girls, that you remember why Jesus came into the world. And I hope you still remember your memory verse. Will you say it with me again? Jesus said, I am the light of the world. I hope you all have a lovely Christmas.